Hello mga kawamat, in this video lesson, we will discuss measures of dispersion. So the extent of the spread or the dispersion of the data described by a group of measures called measures of dispersion, also called measures of variability. So the measures to be considered are the range, average or mean deviation, standard deviation, and the variance. So first is the range. So the range is the difference between the largest and the smallest values in a set of data. So consider the following score obtained by 10 students participating in mathematics contest. So we have 6, 10, 12, 15, 18, 18, 20, 23, 25, and 28. Para makuha natin yung range, kailangan ma-identify natin kung ano yung pinakamababang value at yung pinakamataas. So dito, ang pinakamataas ay 28. And then yung pinakamababa ay 6. So subtract lang natin yon, 28 minus 6. So the answer is 22. So thus, the range is 22. So the scores range from 6 to 28. So, average mean deviation, these measures of spread is defined as the absolute difference or deviation between the values in the data set of data. So, what formula? No, ito yung formula na gagamitin natin. So, the summation of the absolute value of x minus the mean over n. So, ito yung formula para makuha natin yung average deviation. So, for example, a set of observation consists of 20, 60, 75, 85, 98. So, find the average deviation. So, yung unang kukunin natin ay yung mean. So, by using this formula, kunin muna natin yung mean. So, 22 plus 60 plus 75 plus 85 plus 98 divide 5. So, if we're going to add all of this, that is 340. So, kapag dinivide sa 5, the answer is 68. Okay, again, pwede nyo ito double check yung sagot natin sa calculator nyo. And then, after that, apply natin yung formula ng average deviation. So, kunin natin yung difference or yung kapag in-add natin yung the absolute value ng difference nitong value natin and then yung value ng mean. So, yung una yung 22. So, 22 minus 68 plus, so isa-isahin natin, the absolute value of 60 minus 68 plus the absolute value of 75 minus 68 plus the absolute value of 85 minus 68 plus the absolute value of 98 minus 68. So, 22 minus 68, that is negative 46. And 60 minus 68, that is negative 8. 75 minus 68, that is 7. 85 minus 68, that is 17. 98 minus 68, that is 30. So, absolute value of negative 46, that is 46. Absolute value of negative 8, positive 8. The absolute value of 7 is 7. The absolute value of 17, 17. The absolute value of 30 is 30 divide 5. So, kapag in-add natin lahat ito, that is 108. So, 108 divide 5, the answer is 21.6. Ibig sabihin, thus the average distance for the set of data is 21.6 units from the mean. So, yung mean natin is 68. So, again, so the average distance for the set of data is 21.6 units from the mean value na 68. So, ganyan lang kunin yung average deviation. Next, the standard deviation. So, the standard deviation is a measure of how spread out numbers are. So, it is a symbol of this, the Greek letter for sigma. So, for standard deviation of the population, ang symbol na ginagamit natin ito. Okay? So, sigma. Kapag sa sample naman, so nagbago lang ito, naging S lang. S lang yung ginagamit. Pero same pa rin yung orientation ng formula natin. Alright? Sa sample lang, N minus 1 na yung numerator, pero sa population natin, over N. Okay, procedures for computing the standard deviation. First, unahin natin ay compute muna natin yung mean. Okay, then for each number, calculate the deviation or the difference between the number and the mean of the numbers. Calculate the square of each deviation and find the sum of this squared deviation. In the data, if the data is population, then divide the sum by n. If the data is a sample, then divide the sum by n minus 1. And then, the last step is find the square root of the quotient in step number 4. So, for example, the following numbers were obtained by sampling a population. 2, 4, 7, 12, and 15. So, this is sampling, so that sample. So, unang gagawin ay kunin muna natin yung mean. So, we're going to use the formula of mean, the summation of f over n, or the summation of frequencies over n. So, 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 12 plus 15 divide 5. So, if we're going to add all of this, that is 40. 40 divide 5, the answer is 8. Then, yung mean na yan, gagamitin natin sa step 2. Okay, kasi isa-subtract natin, no? Yung bawat isa doon sa mean natin, then kunin ng squared. So that is the squared of 2 minus 8 plus the squared of 4 minus 8 plus the squared of 7 minus 8 plus the squared of 12 minus 8 plus the squared of 15 minus 8. Since sample ito, n minus 1. So yung n natin is 5, 5 minus 1. Kaya naging 5 minus 1 yan. And after that, so isi-simplify natin. So, kapag, by using your calculator, ang makukuha nyo dito is 118. Okay, you can double check, no, using your calculator. That is 118. So, divided by 4, since 5 minus 1 is 4, so the answer is 29.5. So, hindi pa ito, no, kasi kunin pa natin. This will be the standard deviation, the variance rather, not variance pa lang ito. So, kunin pa natin yung standard deviation by getting the square root of your variance. So, square root of 29.5, so yung standard deviation natin is 5.43. Okay, next. Okay, so consider group has tested a sample of 8 size D batteries from each of 3 companies. So, para alam nyo kung ano yung application ng standard deviation. So, the result of the test are shown in the following table. According to this test, which company produces batteries for which the values representing Rs of constant use have the smallest standard deviation? So, meron tatlong company, the Ever So Bright, Dependable, and Bacon. So, ito yung mga samples, no, na na-test. So, bawat company merong tigi 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, we're going to test by computing the standard deviation. So, start with Ever So Bright. So, we just follow the steps na binigay kanina. Una, kunin muna natin yung mean. So, yung mean natin is 7. And then, ito, dinirect na, no? Pwede nyo i-direct ang standard deviation by getting the square root of, tapos ilagay sa loob yung difference, and then yung squared yung difference ng bawat isa. Okay, so kapag sinimplify natin yan, okay, yung the squared of 6.2 minus 7 plus the squared of 6.4 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.1 minus 7 plus the squared of 5.9 minus 7, plus the squared of 8.3 minus 7, plus the squared of 5.3 minus 7, plus the squared of 7.5 minus 7, plus the squared of 9.3 minus 7. If we're going to simplify, divide by 7, so the answer is 12.34 divide 7. E kunin pa natin yung square root nito. So, the square root of 12.34 divided 7 is 1.33 R. So, tatandaan natin, sa Ever So Bright, so yung standard deviation natin is 1.33 R. So, tingnan natin sa Dependable Company. So, yung mean natin dito ay 7 din. Okay, pareho sila kanina ng ever so bright. Ang mean natin is 7. So to compute the standard deviation, same process. So get the square root of the squared of 6.8 minus 7 plus the squared of 6.2 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.2 minus 7 plus the squared of 5.9 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.0 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.4 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.3 minus 7 plus the squared of 8.2 minus 7 all over 7. So if we're going to simplify, that is 3.62, and the square root of 3.62 divides 7, the answer is 0.72 hours. So for the dependable company, the standard deviation is 0.72 hours. Next is for the bacon company. Okay? So yung mean nila 7. So ito yung class, no, parang ano, no, tatlong estudyante na naglalaban kung sino yung top 1. Pareho sila ng average kasi yung kanina 7, 7 din yung pangalo, ito pangatlo 7 din. So paano natin malalaman kung sino talaga yung nanguna? So by using the standard deviation, so kagaya rin dito sa problem natin, pare-pareho sila ng mean. So para ma-identify, no, yung consistent yung use ng battery ay malalaman natin by the using of standard deviation. So again, 7 din yung mean sa pangatlong company. So ang gagawin natin, so same process, get the square root of the squared of 6.1 minus 7 plus the squared of 6.6 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.3 minus 7 plus the squared of 5.7 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.1 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.6 minus 7 plus the squared of 7.1 minus 7 plus the squared of 8.5 minus 7 all over 7. So if we're going to simplify lahat ng nasa numerator natin, that is 5.38. And get the square root of 5.38 divide 7. So the standard deviation per bacon company is 0.88 hours. To summarize, okay, so for Eversoft, we have 1.33. Dependable, we have 0.72. Per bacon, 0.88. So sa tatlong company na to, na pare-pareho yung mean na 7, magkaiba lang yung standard deviation. Sa tingin nyo, sino kaya yung nag-produce na company na consistent, no, yung gamit ng battery? Of course, ang pipiliin natin dyan, yung pinakamababa yung standard deviation. And that is dependable. So in that problems, so the batteries from dependable have the smallest standard deviation. So according to these results, the dependable company produces the most consistent batteries with regards to life expectancy under constant use. Okay, so yan ang gamit ng standard deviations. So standard deviation of group data. So for example, meron tayong given scores and corresponding frequency. So paano natin kukumputin yung standard deviation of group data? So para makompute natin, so kailangan natin kunin yung total number of frequency, and that is 40. And next is the class mark. So paano natin kunin ulit yung class mark? Yung gitna ng mga scores. So add natin itong dalawa, divide it by 2. So the answer is 55.5, 47 plus 52. That is 49.5. So pwede kayong magsimula dito, class, sa baba, kasi nandito yung, dito siya nag-umpisa pataas. So pwede kayong mag-umpisa dito. 5 plus 10, 15 divided to, that is 7.5. So kapag nakuha nyo ito, kunin yung difference, saka add-add na lang. So kasi dito, inuna ko ilagay yung sagot sa taas. For 41 to 46, that is 43.5. For 35 to 40, 37.5. So again, class, kinukuha yung class mark, ina-add natin yung lower limit saka upper limit, divide by 2. And then so 29 to 34, yung class mark natin is 31.5. Dito sa 23 to 28, 25.5. Sa 17 to 22, 19.5. Sa 11 to 16, 13.5. Sa 5 to 10, 7.5. And next is yung FX. Okay, so yung frequency times the class mark. So that is 3 times 55.5. The answer is 166.5. And next is 4 times 49.5. The answer is 198. 1 times 43.5. The answer is 43.5. 2 times 37.5. That is 75. Okay, same with the others, no? So, imu-multiply lang natin. So, and next table is kunin natin din yung summation nito. So, add lang natin lahat and that is 1,212. So, yung next table natin na kukunin natin is yung difference ng mean sa bawat frequency natin. So, before that, kunin muna natin yung mean natin. So, yung mean natin is by dividing the summation of fx over n. So, 1,212 divide 40. The answer is 30.3. So, gagamitin natin yung 30.3. So, para makuha yung difference nung frequency natin min sa 30.3. Okay? Squared natin yon. So, una, that is 25.2 squared. So, ibig sabihin class, ito yon. 30, okay? So, yung x natin, of course, dito is, so that, and then subtract natin. So, the answer is 635.04. And next is 19.2. Okay, 19.2 squared. So, that will become 368.64. Okay, yung kasunod natin. So, 43.5 minus 30.3. So, that is 13.2 squared. So, again, class, ang pag-minus natin is class mark minus yung mean natin. So, 43.5 minus 30.3, that is 13.2 squared. And the answer is 174.24. So, next is 37.5 minus 30.3. So, the answer is 7.2. Then, is squared natin yon. The answer is 51.84. And next, 31.5 minus 30.3, that is 1.44. So, kapag ni-squared natin, that's with 31.5 minus 30.3, and then kapag ni-squared natin yun, 1.44. So, ito, sagot na itong pinapakita dito, no? 23.04, dito naman 116.64, 282.24, and 519.84. So, again, class, paano nakuha ito? Minus natin yung x, okay, by using this formula. So, 55.5 minus 30.3 and then squared natin. Kaya nakuha yung sagot na 635.04. Then, after that, itong sagot natin dito, imumultiply natin sa frequency natin. So, 3 times 635.04, the answer is 1,905.12. 4 times 368.64, the answer is 1,474.56. And then same din dito sa mga susunod na. Okay, so ganun ang pagkuha. Now kunin natin yung summation nito, and that is 6,278.4 ang sagot, no? Summation nito. So, by using the variance formula, okay, kunin muna natin. So, sundan lang natin yung formula na to. So, yung summation nito, and that is 6,278.4 divided by 40 minus 1, since yung n natin is 40, no? And that is 39 na lang. So, 6,278.4 divided by 39. So, yung variance natin is 160.98. E di ba yung standard deviation para makuha, i-square root lang natin yung variance. Okay, para makuha yung standard deviation, get the square root of our variance, and that is square root of 160.98. The answer is 12.69. So, the standard deviation for this given is 12.69.
Thank you. for watching this video. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button para updated kayo for more video tutorial. This is your guide in learning your math lesson, your WowMath channel.